Hello everyone, Ken here, back with another data science video for you. Today I'm talking about how to get data science experience without necessarily having a data science job. I see a lot of people in different forums and in different groups that I'm a part of talking about how they have the necessary skills, but they don't necessarily have the experience needed that a lot of jobs are looking for. So in this video, I'm speaking to the things that I know can look good on a resume and that can perhaps substitute as some real work experience. If you stay tuned to the end, I'll give you my number one best resource for getting data science experience. And as usual, if you enjoy this video, please hit that like button. If you want to see more videos similar to this, please subscribe to my channel and you'll get to see the weekly content that I publish. If you're in school, which many people in this situation are, I really recommend looking at research opportunities within your university. This looks great on your resume. It gets you close to a professor who can perhaps act as a mentor and give you a recommendation. It also gives you, proximity to real-world data science or machine learning projects. And if you get published, that's another feather in your cap. So I would explore all the opportunities here. There's a potential that you also make money from this and that you have maybe some tuition reimbursement. So there's a financial benefit of this avenue as well. The second thing that I would recommend is working on personal projects. I harp on this a lot and I've made multiple videos about this that you'll see above. And this shows a couple of things. It shows that you have interest in data science. It shows that you have initiative. And if you can potentially make money from some of these projects or get them published or get some notoriety around them, that looks really great on your resume. To me, that is real life experience, especially if other people have eyes on them. If you're just doing this for yourself and you can talk about it, but you don't share it, that doesn't hold the same weight as having a project that you socialize and you get feedback on. Because in the real world, when you're working, you're always showing your projects and your work to other people, and you're always getting feedback, criticism, and occasionally praise associated with them. So I would make sure if you are doing projects that you're comfortable with the work and you're finding a medium to share them. I've shared projects on YouTube, obviously. I share some of the work that I do on Medium and also on GitHub. So I recommend not necessarily all three of those sources, but at least make sure that your projects are put in a GitHub repo or whatever Git repository that you use. Going back to the school concept, or for the people who are in school, either in undergraduate or graduate, another way that you can simulate real work experience is through your schoolwork. Schoolwork is graded and it has a somewhat similar feel to your work in the real world. You can show potential employers what your grades were, you can show them what the project was, and again, that is in a way a little bit social, especially if you're sharing your project with the class. So, when you get kind of further along in data science courses, you usually have the opportunity to work on a project through the course that is largely of your choosing. I recommend you choose a field that has some of the qualities related to a good data science project that I talked about before. And to make sure that you really do a good job, you are able to articulate what the schoolwork is about. And if you get a good recommendation or high marks from your teacher, absolutely hype that up on your resume or in the interview process. The next thing that I think is important to point out, the next type of work experience that you can get is an internship. So that is very close to a real job, but there are some pretty stark distinctions. So an internship is a lot easier to get than a full-time job. And you don't necessarily have to be a student, you don't necessarily have to be undergrad or grad student to be able to get an internship. If you really want to get into the field, there's a chance that people will take you even if you're a couple years out of school, because they're getting someone who might be more polished at the intern level. There's a couple internships that I did in between grad school because I wanted to learn some new skills, and I think that this is a completely viable approach. you know, especially if you are an undergrad or a graduate student, this is even better for you because they carve out time where you can potentially get credit for doing internships here. Another benefit of internships is that they usually pay you, and in the data science field, they generally pay you pretty well. So it's nice to have maybe a little extra beer money on the weekend from an internship opportunity. Another area to gain work experience that I really like is Upwork or any of these contracting websites. You probably have to set your rate to be pretty low to make an impact, but or to get potential clients, but you can show your portfolio, you can show the things that you've done, and again, you can make money from this. This is 100% real world experience, and if you can get some exposure to that, there is, you know, a couple added benefits associated with it. So the first is you get the experience of working. The second is that the employer or whoever you're interviewing with knows that you have the initiative and the sales ability to actually win a client. Winning a client is a really hard thing to do. You know, I do a reasonable amount of consulting, and I know how hard it is and how important it is for us to get new clients. That's a long process, but it's something that's very worthwhile if you can do it. The ability to sell yourself, to sell a project, is extremely important in data science. And by doing contract work, you can show that to any potential new employer. Now, my number one most recommended way to get work experience in data science is to do 100% free work for a real client. A lot of people will not turn you down if you're offering a free service and you have a well thought out project. You know, you can talk to people within your network, you can talk to nonprofits who are always looking for this type of work. And I think that that is a great way for you to learn skills, to put something on your resume, and to help a greater good, help a good cause. Employers love to see when people are charitable, when they're working for nonprofits or working with nonprofits. And again, that is another kind of kudos to you that they will see that will really help you going forward. Now, this again does take a little bit of salesmanship. It does take you going out there and introducing yourself and meeting these people. And you know, it can start as free work, but it can eventually turn into paid work or even a full-time job. So don't think, oh, I'm doing this for free, like my skills are, you know, I should be being paid infinitely more than this. It is planting the seed for something bigger. And that's what all of these things are. You're planting a bunch of seeds in your projects and your internships and any of the pro bono work that you do to create a great opportunity for you going forward. So with that in mind, thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope it helps, and good luck on your data science journey.